good if I put this on your legs?
Yeah, go for it.
God damn it.
Welcome, everyone. Thank you for attending this press conference, the third rally of Pittsburghers indicting the systemic injustices which allowed George Zimmerman to go consequence-free for 6 weeks before being charged, and then to be found not guilty following the murder of Trayvon Martin. This rally is a continuation, building on those at Mellon Park and the rally and sit-in demonstrations at Freedom Corner this past Sunday. We have written a list of demands to overhaul the institutional and ecumenical condition of Black Pittsburgh. When met, these demands will directly impact and improve quality of life in Black Pittsburgh, as well as aid in the retention of greater numbers of Pittsburghers of color. These are a must before the city of Pittsburgh can be considered one of the most livable for all. Again, I'd like to thank each and every person here for coming. The power and most valuable aspect of these events is in our togetherness. May we continue to process, cry out, converse, tweet, heal, sing, and fight together. We know you have much passion, you have much to say, and we want to hear you too. Please find those wearing green armbands and share. In what ways do you wish Pittsburgh to improve for equality and justice? What are your demands?
Now we're going to have Ayanna read the statement that was written. This is a collective statement from those who chose to take the street and sit in on Sunday, July 14th. We, Shaquille Adams, Rhea Thomas, Joy Kimmett, Becca Zaley Mugooney, Natasha Mays, Quinn Elliott, Amy Magham, Jamie Magham, Raymond Peterson, and allies are responding in solidarity with every Black victim of injustice. We are enraged by the verdict of not guilty for George Zimmerman. We are committed to disrupting what passes for justice as usual. As residents of Pittsburgh, we say from our own experiences as Black people that Pittsburgh is not America's most livable city. We are calling for an end of the criminalization of Black people, Black bodies, and the Black community. We should be valued because we are human beings. Our lives and the lives of our children are precious. This press conference protests the systemic injustices, racism, white supremacy, and brutalization of Black people in Pittsburgh, in this country, and around the world. In the words of Asada Shakur, repeat after me, it is our duty to fight.
It is our duty.
Envision what we want for Pittsburgh that values racial
justice and human rights for all of its citizens. And out of that, we have created an extended list of demands for not only the formal powers that be in this community, but also the informal powers that be. And so I'm going to introduce Becca Zela and Mbuni and Joy Yejide Kimmet to come up. They will actually read for you some of the demands that will be delivered to our leaders just right after this press conference. Please give them a round of applause. Joy and Becca Zela.
Of power.
Yeah. Yeah.
and are held accountable for demonstrations of white privilege and supremacy. In response to the emotional and physical violence inflicted on Black communities, we demand culturally relevant emotional support for Black communities in response to trauma. We demand the City of Pittsburgh create a human rights bill as an active demonstration of the inalienable right for all to be, the immeasurable value of the lives, bodies, and minds of all oppressed people, and a commitment to true physical and emotional justice for oppressed people within the City of Pittsburgh. Yes. Finally, we demand the City of Pittsburgh hold the tragic death of Trayvon as a wake-up call to the culture of white supremacy that produces, protects, and inflicts emotional, institutional, legal, economic violence on Black lives and bodies. We demand Pittsburgh renounce America's most livable city title until these demands are met.
We're going to follow the people who sat and
obstructed the street at Freedom Corner to, we're gonna follow them into the city county building, and then we'll go up from there. We ask that you be quiet as you enter the building, and then once we get up to the fifth floor, we'll wait, and then we'll wait for the whole group to join us, and then we will present our stand.
Love. divides us when we don't all stand for the same thing. It's easy for me as a black mother of a teenage boy to speak out. But for white people and black people to stand together, that's what Martin Luther King was referencing to. Because if it affects us, it will affect you eventually.
Pass it on.
It's in your hand.
Right now, we have a public hearing.
Sorry.
No, this is a public hearing. You're racist.
Okay. Pittsburgh walk proud.
The mayor!
and wait for the mayor, but we
have to be quieter.
Yeah, we would not be able to.
That's around
the mouth. We were continuing to be loud.
So, is he gonna come out?
No, they're mouthing to throw him out right now.
Okay, folks, listen up. I will receive your demands. The mayor is unable to meet with you right now.
See, this is the problem right here. See, this is the problem right here because we cannot get any justice for Trayvon Martin, but you got all these police officers defending the mayor from his constituents. This is the issue.
If you would like him to hear your demands, I am able to take them to you. You have a letter for him.
We have a letter for him.
How do we hold you accountable for your delivery?
You can email me. My email address is my first name.
You got a smartphone? You got a smartphone? I'm going to see a video of you reading the demands of the mayor.
By the way, this situation affects you too. Doesn't only affect black folks. It affects you too. It's a domino effect.
I was just at the rally with you. I completely understand your demands.
We appreciate it. We need accountability.
Okay, let him be done.
I do not know his schedule.
You don't know the schedule, but you're his assistant?
I'm not the schedule.
We need 5 minutes.
We need 5 minutes.
He's willing to take it to the mayor, so just try to make all nice and peaceful, that's all.
He needs the mayor.
Hold on 5 minutes.
We need the accountability.
He needs to take the mayor.
demands to the mayor. If you would like, two of you would like to meet with me and Olivia right now in the small conference room, we are more than willing to do that. And then we will have a full understanding of your demands and be able to explain them exactly to the mayor for you.
Why did he swipe? Did he give you a reason why he himself cannot come?
He's in a meeting right now. He's unable to meet with you right now. Contact information
no.
Now.
Until 2 o'clock.
Well, first of all, it's not my meeting to chair. It's the council president's, and so she has purview on this right now. I don't know how long you guys are going to be here.
The mayor said things are changing.
Okay, but
the mayor's going to meet with Joy.
Good.
Hello.
But maybe after the meeting, if some of you are still here and you have stayed, maybe that's going to be an opportunity.
I just we're going to have a resolution that we want you to pass.
Really important to recognize that you are here and to give you that opportunity to be heard.
Thank you.
The mayor is indeed coming out. We're going to do our hearings in chamber. Perhaps you will still be here after the hearing is over, and then we'll handle that when the time comes. Okay?
Right. Thank you.
But I thank you all for being here and taking such an active
part.
We are
about to deliver the letter into the mayor's office, and we wanted to let y'all know that yes, what's happening.
People.
to him, because we're not going to give it to anyone else but him. Is that all right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Do you think that he left the building?
He did. He did. He's not here.
He left since we've been here?
Yep. Yeah.